So let's say I'm a proxy and I want to put a key value pair in the Coral DHT. I'm going to use the key-based routing algorithm to place the key at an appropriate node. What does that mean? Well, I'm going to take the key, and even if I have the node ID that is equal to this key, I'm not going to go to him directly. Remember that the Coral key-based routing algorithm reduces the distance by half. So I'm going to go to a node that is half the distance to the desired destination. So the desired destination is N. I'll go to a node that is half the distance, say N over 2, N over 4, and so on, till I get to the desired destination. And as I'm going, making these calls, saying that, well, I'm progressing towards this desired destination node, using that key-based routing algorithm that uses the XOR distance between the source and the destination, having the distance at every step, what I'm going to ask is, are you loaded or full? These two states that we talked about. And this guy says, no, I'm not loaded or full. And here is the next hop you can go to. So I keep going forward. And if none of these guys say that they are loaded or full, I would eventually reach my desired destination and place the key value over there. However, when I do this hop, going from half the distance to one-fourth the distance and so on, somebody along the way may say that, look, for this particular key that you're trying to place, I'm already full or loaded. One of those two conditions is already applying to me. So this node responds back to me and says, I am either loaded or full. If that is the response I get back, then what I'm going to infer from that response is that the rest of the distance going towards the destination is all clogged up because of the tree saturation. And therefore, I'm not going to even try to place the key value pair at the desired destination, and not even at this guy, because he's also loaded and or full for the same key. And so I'm going to retract my step and choose this node as the node to place the key value pair. So in other words, when I do a put operation, there are two phases to it. The first phase is the forward phase. In the forward phase, what we are doing is we are going to the guy that is half the distance to the desired destination, asking him, are you full or loaded? He says, no, I'm not. Then you go to the next guy who is even closer to the desired destination. He says he's not full or loaded. Then you go to the next guy who is even closer, using that key-based routing algorithm that I described to you earlier. So you keep going till you hit a node that is either loaded or full. At that point, you know you don't want to go any further towards the desired destination because all of these guys are either loaded or full dealing with this particular key. And therefore, the second phase of the algorithm that I'm going to use is retract my steps and go back and ensure that this guy is still willing to host my key value pair. Why would he change his mind? Well, between the time that I was making this forward motion, it is possible that this guy got either full or loaded. So I'll recheck the condition. If he says, still I'm good to host your key value pair, I'll choose this node for the put operation. That's how the Coral put operation works. So you can see that we are not storing the key in the desired destination, which should have been the way a greedy algorithm would have worked. But in the sloppy algorithm of Coral, we choose an appropriate node that is neither full nor loaded so that it can entertain requests for retrieving this particular key value pair. So we've avoided the Meta server overload by doing this key-based routing in the forward path doing the put operation. So the get operation is going to do exactly similarly. That is, given a key that I'm looking for, I'm not going to go directly to the destination that might be hosting it, as would happen in the greedy approach. But instead, what I would do is go to a node that is half the distance to the key that I'm looking for. And when I do that, my hope is I'll find the key somewhere along the way, because some guy may be serving as the metadata server for that particular key. If not, I will go to the destination. If nobody has retrieved that key before, it will be available at the desired destination. I'll get it from there. But the hope is that if a content is popular enough, then multiple people, multiple proxies may have gotten the key value pair, and therefore, and they may have gotten the key value pair, and in turn, when they have gotten the content as well, they would have put their own node IDs as a potential node for the content. And so our metadata server, when we are looking for a particular key, may not necessarily have to be the destination which exactly matches that key.